In today's video, I'm going to show you an easy way to join your binding ends. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I'm the creator and host of The Quilter's Way, an online private club where members learn and grow in a fun and supportive community. You can check out all the details at thequiltersway.com. Now, before I get into today's topic, I'd love it if you'd subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. This is a video I recorded a little while ago, actually, but I wanted to share it with you today so that if you have problems joining your binding ends, you'll have found an easy way to do that by watching today's video. One of the things I've had problems with over the years is joining my binding strips when I'm finishing off my quilt. And you may have the same issues I do. It's kind of confusing. And you want it to just fit perfectly, and you want a nice mitered seam so you really can't tell where the join is and everything. So I've tried different things over the years, and I've tried different notions, but I finally settled on this one technique that seems to work really well. So I have made up a mock little quilt sandwich here just to show you how this works. So it's not hard at all. You just need to follow me along step by step, and I'm sure you're going to love this technique too. So let's take a closer look at what you need to do. So as I said, I've mocked up a little quilt sandwich here. So this would be your regular quilt, and here's your two binding edges coming together. And one thing you need to do is make sure that you leave yourself enough room. So you don't want to be struggling trying to join these little binding strips and you don't have any room or anything. So make sure when you start your binding that you leave yourself a generous, like I probably got at least a foot here extra. You could leave like somewhere between 8 and 10 inches of unjoined binding strip. And you go along, and then when you stop on the other side, make sure you stop at least 10 inches away from where you started. So you also need to leave some binding strip. Don't need to leave quite as much here. I've probably got somewhere between 8 and 10 inches there, something like that. But leave this extra space in between. So that's an important thing to do when you're starting and when you're stopping. So now I have all these extra pieces. What am I going to do with them? Well, I'm going to take my longer piece here. I'm going to move it along, and then I'm going to actually cut that off. So I'm going to move it along about halfway along there. I want to give myself a little bit of a mark there to cut along because I'd like to have it nice and straight. So I'm going to cut right there. You could cut it with your rotary cutter if you wanted to as well. And then I'm going to put that over the side. Now I'm going to take this other piece, and it's going to go and overlap. So I can feel the edge of my binding strip there. If I want to look, I can look and see there it is there. And I want to cut this one off too, because I don't want to have all this extra to join. But how far do I cut it off? Well, it's really easy. What I do is I take off the piece I just cut off, because what you're going to do is you're going to take the edge there that you can feel where I already cut the first binding strip, and you're going to cut this strip the same width as what the binding strip width is. Sounds a lot of widths in there, doesn't it? So the easiest thing to do is to take off the cut off piece of binding strip, line it up at the edge there with the one that's cut underneath. Remember, we cut that one off underneath. So I'm going to line it up there. Make sure I'm lined up in the right spot here. That's the first thing. And if you're not sure, you can always look. You can just peek underneath and do this. Now, this is as far over as I want to cut. I'm going to make a little mark there for me. That always helps. And I'm going to cut just a little short of that, just so it's going to fit nice and snug. So I'm going to cut over here probably about 1/8 of an inch. Now, one of the things you want to do is make sure you pull that strip away from the bottom. You don't want to end up cutting that bottom one off. That would not be good. So I'm going to cut, let's see, about there. There we go. Okay. So I have these extra binding pieces. I can leave those. So now that I've got them cut properly, I need to join them together. So what you're going to do is open up the strips and join them right sides together with a diagonal seam. So you'll put them together just like this, and you will probably want to add a few pins in here to hold it. You want to line up your edges, of course. Sometimes that takes a little bit of fussing. That's okay. And then you're going to put a couple of pins in just to hold them in place. And then you want to stitch from here to here. Now, I'm not good about eyeballing that when I'm stitching, so I'm actually going to mark that. So what you're looking at is the edge of the one strip to the edge of the other strip. And you can see this is why you wanted to leave that extra space initially, because it's a bit fussy. Okay, let me get this down here and down there. Okay. So you can see that looks pretty good. All right. So the next thing to do is to go to the sewing machine and stitch along that diagonally drawn line. And I'm going to go do that now. So I finished sewing along that diagonal seam. You can see that it's stitched along here. And then I need to cut off this extra. So I'm just going to eyeball it with my scissors and cut off about a quarter inch away from that seam allowance. From that seam, I should say. Okay, get rid of that. So this is what's going to happen now. It's just like magic. Watch. Ta-da! So there we go. We've got a nice mitered seam. You're not going to see it very well. But let's go back inside here because you do have this seam here. So you can either press it open or press it to one side, whichever you prefer. I often press them open. You can just finger press it, or I have this little Violet Craft seam roller that I like to use. I'll just press that down there. And then we're going to have it come along here, and we'll just give that a little press as well. So the next thing we need to do is finish sewing it. So let's go back to the sewing machine and stitch that binding on. So now I've got my binding all sewn down and it fit perfectly. So here it is, all sewn on, and I just need to trim some of the threads off there, but you can see it's ready to fold over and be hand stitched on. So I find this is a really easy method to use, and you don't have to worry about getting any tools or anything like that. So if you've been struggling to join your binding ends, I hope you'll give this a try. I know it's going to work out really well for you too. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And if you'd like more helpful quilting information, go to chatterboxquilt.com.